Mocha Pro already offers some of the best ML-assisted rotoscoping tools in the business. In this video, you'll learn how the latest version of Mocha Pro now offers various ML edge refinements to get your mats even closer to completion, regardless of how they were made. I'm Grant K for Boris Effects, and let's get started. So here we have a shot where we've been asked to remove some details on the wall. Using a series of planar tracking techniques with Mocha Pro, the wall has been cleared, and our foreground subjects need to be rotoed back into the shot. To do this, the original shot is duplicated to the top of the composite, and you would apply Mocha Pro to the layer. Click the button to launch Mocha Pro. In case you have never seen these menus before, I am working in the classic layout, which shows all of Mocha Pro's controls. Now, for this particular shot, we typically advise you to break it up with multiple splines in order to simplify the work. So we have a couple of manually tracked splines for the male and one ML tracked spline for the female. I'm not going to go into detail of how this was done, as there are plenty of tutorials on the Boris Effects training page and YouTube channel. What we do want to focus on are the edges of the mats. So let's display all the mats in the shot and turn off the color channels and matte colors. Looking closer at the edges, irrespective of whether we created these manually or with ML-assisted tools, we need to recover as much edge detail as possible. Starting with the spline for the woman, you need to be looking at the matte's parameters. Here you will find a function called Refine Layer Matte. This is a new feature to Mocha Pro, and when we enable it, it uses an ML model to refine the edges. There are in fact two models to choose from. You have one for softer edges and one for sharper edges. Pick whichever one works best for you. Now we can refine this mat further with the extra parameters, but feel free to experiment. The great thing about Refine Layer Mat is that we can also select the male's hair and refine that too, even though this spline was manually created. If the visible splines are getting in the way, just disable the overlays. Currently, we are using two ML processors on two separate splines. So the ML has to run twice to produce one result. That's absolutely fine, but it's not optimal for your processing power. Let's quickly take a look at a new grouping functionality to streamline the process. Firstly, let's rewind a bit and remove the edge refinement on both subjects. Next, select both the woman and the man hair layers, right-click, and choose Group Selected. This creates a group from those layers, and you can rename it to whatever you want. Now, depending on how you approach this, you might notice our group's mats vanished, but the overlays are still there. This is not a problem. Just enable Composite Layer in Group. Our grouped mats reappear, and now everything in this group is treated as one mat. What's the benefit? Well, if we turn on Refine Layer Mat again, both mats are refined with one ML process. Much more efficient. Scrubbing through the result, we get a workable mat for our subjects, and we're almost done. Click the button to save the Mocha Pro project and return back to the host. I'll start caching the composite to see the result. Already I can tell that the female subject looks fine, but the male subject has some small issues with the edges of his hair. As always, AI and ML will definitely get you most of the way, but it's not bulletproof. So here I have one more layer for his hair, using a few traditional keying techniques to bring out a bit more detail on the edges. This is the before, and this is the after with masking and ML edge refinement. If you have any questions or feedback, please feel free to let us know in the comments. We also have the official Boris Effects forums, as well as the Boris Effects Discord server for bigger discussions. I'm Grant K for Boris Effects, and see you next time.